Here we go, the game's on. After all, Garrow Tracy has it. Down he goes, he's fouled. No, the referee plays on. Referee David Moore from St. Joseph's. Free in, ball within it. And Liam Dunn there. Harsh free, but the ref has given the foul. The Cavan man will have to worry of that. Portwood have a good free tackle here now. Down here in the programme is Colin Winston, number 13 anyway. For free. First chance of a score, only after 30 seconds of the match. And looks good from here. Looks good. Umpire is unsure. He raises it up. First point of the game to Portwood. Man. Number 10, Michael Connolly, have it down us. Here comes Portwood on the break. Has he been fouled yet? The referee's blown. He's tugging the jersey there. Ball in. Number 17 has it again. Good possession. They're looking to break here. Here's Donoher. This is dangerous now for Portwood. On the attack. He stepped back in. Oh, the ref's giving a free. It's a harsh free. He's giving it for a tug there. Ronan Gurry got back and defended there. And that was a dangerous situation. A great counter attack. Great attack there from Portwood. They're looking to penetrate at speed through the middle, so Cavan will have to watch for that. But the ref is giving a free in there now. I thought it was harsh that time. He's giving the free. Seven minutes gone of the match. Still only one score in the game. 1 point to Portwood. Another free for them. Will they make it 2-0? This from the right side. He has done. 2 points to no score to Portwood. There's Sean again, Sean Mangan on the Mangan Twins. Ball in, but ball into the spare quarterman. Wasted possession again for Kilcavan. Just giving away the ball needlessly. Here's Donoher again, the danger man. He's on the ball, he's setting up everything. Out to Wilson, full forward, he has it. He's going for the right boot. It's a good kick, it looks to be a good. Good score, great score by Wilson. Jim Wright, the fullback, is going to have to get tighter here. He's plenty of time to win it and turn there. Jim's going to have to get tighter. It's 3 scores. 3 points, no score for Portwood. 10 minutes gone now. 3 points to no score. Cavan really need a point at this stage just to settle things down, settle the nerves. Oh, spill ball, but Michael Birmingham, centre back, has it. Ball broke off the road. Michael, simple ball and Holly Dixon. Who's he looking for? He's driving into the full forward line, but there's no joy coming off this ball. Every ball, Mangan's looking to win this one, that's it. Great tackle by Sean Mangan. Brilliant tackle, fair shoulder to shoulder. No malice, and the ref gives him a free. And 13 is down. A great tackle by Sean Mangan there. Perfectly timed. That's what we like to see in Gaelic football. A fair challenge, shoulder to shoulder. That something like that can lift the team. So hopefully this will lift the cabin now. That's a great challenge by Sean Mangan. Corner with the free now, half possession. Looking to build. Donoher again, the danger man. He seems to be very loose. I'm not sure who's marking it. The ball's bounced loose. Dangerous. Oh no! And it's a goal! It's broke. Very unfortunate to Cavan. The ball bounced in the penalty area. And the mark on it bounced funny, in fairness. It bounced straight up rather than forward. And Eamon O'Brien came up. The fullback had it. No one called. Eamon O'Brien crashed into the fullback. And the ball is spilled, and a soft goal for Portwood. Great start for Portwood. That's 1-3. 1-3 to no score. Time for Kilcavan to really get into this match now. Before it's too late. This could be over before it even begins. Donoher on the ball. Romero straight over the bar. Another wide there for Portwood. They're starting to dominate now. Kilcavan are panicking the slight, but they need to settle down. Their tactic, they've brought Ronan Gorry is coming out, and he's trying to mark Niall Donoher, who's going on to our midfielder, Garrow Tracy, which means two men marking one man, which is leaving a free man for Portwood. But Ronan has it now. Ronan's on the break. Ronan Gorry's bursting out of place. Number 5's after him. Can Ronan use his speed to get it? Score. He has it again. 1-2 with Ollie Dixon. He's going for the point. He has it. That's exactly what Cavan needed. A great score by Ronan Gorry. Cavan have it out to Declan Roy. Can they build from here now? Build from the back. Keep possession. giving away possession, but Ollie Dixon has it now. Or Michael Birmingham, sorry. Michael Birmingham, what's it there? Poor pass by Michael. He was in two minds. But it was a pass, long range or short pass, and he was in two minds, caught in two minds, and he miskicked it. Corrin having it again, this is dangerous, don't. We don't want the foul because they've been penalised. There's a cut for over carrying. The referee has been consistently penalised Dixon a second goal. He's penalised Corwood here. And Kilcavan take it quick. On again, Sean Mangan off to Tarpey. Tarpey gets it, but he's on the 45 now and he has it. So they need to keep it and build a scoring chance. Keep possession, keep possession. That's it, into Ronan Gorry. Ronan can take on his man. He's the pace here. He's the pace to beat him. He's taking on his man again. Ronan Gorry's causing trouble here again. Can he take a score? It's a great score again! Ronan Gorry, great score! Kilcavan have needed a lift, and Ronan is the man. If they can find him in space, he has the pace to beat a couple of markers at that time. If they can keep finding him, he's the pace to beat his man and create opportunities. If Kilcavan can keep finding him, he's the danger man. Another kick out again for the Corhood. Big kick out. Go straight. A great catch again by Tracy. Brilliant catch. And on to Ronan's brother, Patrick. Ball into Ollie Dixon. Poor ball, sloppy pass, and Ollie's fouled. Simple pass is needed then, but he won it, Ollie. He's looked for the quick one. Oh no! There was a scoring chance, he looked for the quick one. It wasn't accurate enough to pass, and young man had spilled it, but it. And he's off for overcarrying. Well done, great pressure there, my Michael Tarpey. Never give up on it. He never gave up, and he's brought forward. That's great persistence by Michael Tarpey, showing all his experience. Man of the match in the last 10 points, Kilcavan won the Junior A in 2004. And the Kilcavan crowd are getting their voice up here now. Ollie Dixon with the free. And he put it over, just tapped it over. That's a great score. It's three in a row for Kilcavan now. They haven't given up, they haven't dropped their heads. The men in maroon and white are back in this game. Good position by Ron, but who's marking? A free man loose inside, number 7 again. Don't foul, the referee has been penalising any half foul even. Oh, poor kick by number 17. But it's up in the air, it's dangerous, it could go anywhere this one. Oh, it's a great catch by this corner, or the full forward. And there's a man inside for Corwood, they can find him. The camera caught napping here. Caught napping at the back. But a point! They've got a point of it. A point, but there was a goal chance on that the Corwood man had slipped inside. So they'll take that to Kilcavan, they got away with just a point. Another point up now. Corner will take it quick though. Are Kilcavan alert to this? No, they're not. They've been caught sleeping again. It's not for the first time. Kilcavan have been caught sleeping for the quick one. The quick possession is causing loads of problems. But hey, Liam Hayes done now with the ball. That's a brilliant. The ref was given no free here. I can't believe it. Surely he was fouled. Kilcavan break. Pat Hunt, he had to get into the game. Another good ball. Up to Tarpey. Tarpey with it. But Ronan has it again. The danger man, Ronan Gorry, breaks onto it. Can he win the opportunity? It's true. Ronan Gorry, true 1-1. Out to Derek and I. And Derek O'Connor's going to say, it's a goal! A goal for Kilcavan! Ronan Gorry, absolutely brilliant so far. Corbett still have it. Number 12. Keep using his over-rapid runs through the middle. Kilcavan have to be onto this. Good tackling, good hustle by Grow Tracy. And it's paid off. Tracy and young Mangan, Barry, worked out well. Sean Mangan's pushing through the middle now. The simple ball was needed. Up to Derek. It popped out his chest. He still has it though, Derek. And is he fouled? No free, says the referee. Oh, harsh. He looked like he got the boot to it. In fairness to him. And his arms around him. A harsh decision by David Moore, the referee in night. That was a good opportunity for Kilcavan. It just spilled out Derek's hands, the initial one. He held it. It's a scoring opportunity on. Here comes Corford again. Number 13. He's causing lots of problems here. He's coming out the field more and more. It's a dangerous high ball in. Eamon O'Brien's cover. He's missed. He spilled it. Where is it going to go? 14. 14 has it. And he's taking his score. Eamon O'Brien out again. He spilled that. He has to be holding those balls. That's number 14, that's his second score of the match. I know you couldn't put that down to Jim White's fault there, because the ball was well in control of Eamon O'Brien and goals. He should have held it. He's gone for another one out the wing. The last one went over the line. He's gone for this again. It hasn't worked out again. 13 has it. Oh, but he spilled it. And Sean Mangan has it. It's simple pass out. They're under pressure, oh, they're under pressure. You want to watch yourself here, out over the Pat Hunt. God, he hasn't been in the game much so far. He's playing almost a sweeping role. As he only does a good ball here. And Tony Dixon, he's looking for the fresh. It's a great ball in over the top, and Derek has it. And he's in over the keeper. But he stands up. Oh, penalty. It has to be a penalty. The referee took the legs off. Derek O'Connor, it is a penalty. Derek tried to play on and went for the shot and missed the hit wide. But the referee rightly let play go on and gave it as a penalty. Clear foul. An absolutely super ball in there by Oliver Dixon. Caught the defender napping, and Derek read it perfectly. In over the top of the defender's head. He won possession. The keeper came out, took the legs from under Derek. And now he hooked the Cavan with a penalty opportunity. This should tie up the match. It's 1-6 to 1-3 at the minute. 6 points to 9. Michael Tarp is going to take the penalty. Can he win it? The keeper must stay in his line now. We'll see whether the referee penalise him. Keeper, according to the program, Thomas Beaton is his name. The surface out there looks quite bubbly around the header. Mick Tarp is going to take it. His left foot kicker. Mick Tarp, he saved it! But he has it again! And it's in the second time! Oh, it's done, Mick Tarp! He kept his head in fairness. The keeper made a great save. No along the ground, Tarp hit it. A bit close to the keeper's body, but a good save nonetheless by the goalie. It bounced out. Tarp didn't panic. Ball came back out to him. Picked it up and slotted it home. Another great goal for Kilcavan. That's to have them right back in it. A poor start. 1-4. 1-4 to no score, you remember it was. Well, Kilcavan have got 2-3 to 2 score. 2 points in a lap since then. Brilliant response. Draw match here. We have it. A great final now we have in our hands. Who's going to do it? A good kick out. Pushing the back. Yeah, the hands in the back. By Ronan. On number 12, Corbin up for the quick break as usual. Through the middle, this is how they're bearing fruit. Good pressure by Kilcavan, Ollie Dixon and young Barry Mangan. Good pressure in there, they're gone for the long route. This is dangerous, the 14 is causing problems. Pushing the back, I thought. Jamai has it, no. Pressure on, don't foul. Oh, a very harsh free again by the referee. David Moore is really penalising any hand in there at all. It looked to be Mick Birmingham with the hand in, but it was seen very harsh. Very harsh indeed, but Kilcavan will have to watch that. He's penalising him every time. He's having words in number 14 there again as well. Number 14, I think they're saying Jim White was pushing, but it looked to be the other way around, in fairness. Jim White was trying to get in front of the ball. Kilcavan man told Michael to move back. Michael Birmingham here. As Kilcavan subs warm up on the line. Forward another free. It should be straightforward for the free taker, and it is another point. And the ref, there's the halftime whistle. 1-7, 10 points, 2-3, a point in it. But after 1-4, to no score, after 13 minutes gone, it was looking very poor for Kilcavan. But the men in maroon and white have dug in.